Hi everyone, so I'm back to share a little journal with you. This journal is just a combination, it's eclectic, it's a combination of lots of different things, lots of collage papers, lots of ephemera, like digital ephemera, and I will kind of mention everything as I go through. So it's a little journal, it is 6.5 by 4, so it would fit nicely in your bag. You know, easily carried around with you rather than, you know, the big ones that you can't really like carry them around. It's got one signature, there's 48 pages front and back, and it will be listed for sale in my shop and you'll find the link for that below. So the cover here is cardstock, then I printed this digital collage paper, which is from Artie Mays, and it's the Builder Cluster Tag Kit. You get a few collage pages in that kit, so I used one of them. And then here we've just got a simple topper. There's three layers here and that's been stitched as well. And we've got this little girl on there, isn't she cute? Eyelets and string as a closure. And let's go inside. And I've just messed that up. Okay, right. So these papers are from my Elements kit, and that will be linked below, and I shrunk that down. I think it was about 80% because I wanted to make a little journal, so I think that's what I shrunk that down to. But obviously it does come in a full size page, like A4 page. Then here we've got a little pocket. The pocket is made from some paper from Artie Mays. This element here is embellishment is from my Elements kit, and the little number on there is from Tracy Fox. That's from the, I think it's called the Random Labels, I think that's what it's called. This is from Artie Mays's Oddment kit. There's a few Oddment kits, but I can't remember which one. The postcard here is from Nick the Booksmith, and this is a freebie from Artie Mays. It's from quite a long time ago, so I'm not sure where that is. I think it could possibly be on her website, I'm not sure. Here is a little tag, and I decorated that with like a double oval. The little girls here, butterfly, the word vintage. Got a little tag there, coffee dyed, and it says just a knot. And the paper there is from the old design shop. So that goes in there. Then you've got some writing space. These were like the negatives from when I was using making the ovals, or wanting the ovals, and I'd used some of this like brown packaging paper, so I kept all the kind of like the negatives of that, and I used one of them to create a pocket. It's got a window here, we've got a butterfly and a little specimen number label there from Artie Mays. Inside there we have this tag, and that is from the old design shop, and that is from the Etsy store and not the blog. So that goes in there. Then here we've got a little sticker, we've got another little label there, that's from Artie Mays. Then this is a little tag ephemera holder. I've done a Craft With Me video on how to make that, so I'll link that on the screen at the end, but it was the last video that I made. You probably may have watched it. So that's that. We've got that ephemera inside there with a little tag. That closes, goes around. Got a little bead dangle here, which was from Artie Mays. And then here we've got, I embellished that as well. That is butterfly from Artie Mays. Excuse me. The word is from one of the what's that kit called? I just said it. Builder Cluster. Little tag, little postcard. That goes in there. So if you want to see how to make it, there's another one in the journal. But if you want to see how I made that, then check out my last video. Or like I said, I will have it at the end of the screen. At the end of the video on the screen. I always get that muddled up. So we've got some coffee dyed paper here. We've got a pocket. This was some of the collage paper, the ovals that I've got loads of, little bit of layering here, the word explore. Inside there we have this little journal card from Artie Mays. That is from the old design shop on Etsy, and that is from Artie Mays's oddment kit. And that paper here is from my Elements kit. The label is from Tracy Fox. Then here I just made a little pocket. This is from my Elements, and then there's the background there is possibly from Artie Mays, but that's from my Element kit. Then here we've got a library card, and this is a freebie on my coffee shop. That's linked below as well. And then this is from the Elements kit as well. Little half page there, another one here, another little sticker. This is from, I think, the old design shop. Got another pocket there. This is from the Elements kit. Inside there, we've got a little Tiffany & Co. tag. And then we have the library card there. The centre of the signature. Then here, I've got a little flip out, like so. And the paper here is from the Builder Cluster tag kit. And they were just loads of the little double ovals that I've made, with the little girls, the butterfly, the word explorer. And inside there we've just got a little kind of tri-fold, just coffee dyed paper with some corner punching, and then I've just inked it all up, pop that in there. Then we have the Tiffany & Co. stamped coffee dyed tag, and the little paper clip is holding it all together. Little sticker there. Then here we've got another fold out or flip out. This tag is from the Builder Cluster tag kit. Postcard is from Nick the Booksmith. This is from my Elements kit. And that is like so. And that page is from my Elements kit as well. Here again, this is from the Elements kit. The little number label is Artie Mays's oddment kit. This is from one of the oddment kits. That's from Nick the Booksmith. That is a freebie from Artie Mays. Some coffee dyed papers here again, using the oval, but what I done with the oval was I got loads of little scrap pieces of collage paper, so I just topped it onto there, added a butterfly, added a label from Tracy Fox, and then inside here we've got a little tag from the old design shop, and then again this is a freebie from Artie Mays, and this is another one of the tag ephemera tags holders. And like I said, I've got a video on how to make these. I was inspired by someone else, but theirs was slightly different, so just kind of done my own thing. Decorated the back here with a ephemera piece from my Elements kit and a butterfly. They're a freebie from Artie Mays. This is from my Elements kit. And then the lovely little dangle again, that is from Artie Mays. And then here we've got, this is from my Elements kit. It's a part of the collage paper, and it just worked out nicely that that's roughly what I had left, and I made it into a tag. This is from my Elements kit as well, and it closes like so, and you wrap that around, and that is a little flip as well, so that is just paper clipped on like so. Little label there from Tracy Fox, another little sticker, another one of these window pockets, and a tag from the old design shop, and that was the like the leftovers from what I like this. So obviously when I used that I got two out of it, but you could actually do like a double one, or make it like a specimen type card. Butterfly label, here just a little collage tag. The ticket is from Artie Mays, so is that, and the butterfly. And then a little tag that says unforgettable moments. That just tucks in there. Then here we've got a little pocket with this piece is from the Elements kit. Another little library card there that is from Nick the Booksmith. So is that. And so is that. Okay, doesn't want to go in. There we go. And then that is the back page. So that is the little journal. And like I said, that will be in my shop if you're interested. I also have the Dragonfly Dreams journal, which is still available in my shop if you're interested. I'll put that on the end of the screen as well if you haven't already seen that video. If you have any questions, just ask, and thanks for watching. Bye.